Hello everybody, Tim Norris here, aka GreyElephant.
And Carmen Norris.
And welcome to another exciting live play by GreyElephant Gaming. What are we playing today?
Today we are playing Masmorra, Dungeons of Arcadia.
Yeah, and this was sent to us by Cool Mini or Not. Now, what we are going to do is the co-op mode of this game. We're going to work together, we're going to try to defeat the big bad guy, and try to save the day. Will we be successful? Well, we'll find out. Alright everybody, here we are. We are in the dungeon, the Masmorra dungeon, the Dungeons of Arcadia. I am playing as Jay, the human warrior, and who are you, Carmen?
I am Valerie, the human cleric.
Yes, and as you can tell, we're going to try to play in two different modes. We're going to have an overhead shot, and we will also have our first person view like we normally do as well. So how do we play? Well, this is not necessarily a game that I can just sit here and explain, but I will tell you the concept. We are trying to explore the first level, which will be 11 tiles that we have to get through, the first floor of the dungeon, and then we will go through, we'll find some stairs, we'll go down into the second level, the seventh one will be another set of stairs, which will then lead us into either the throne room, whoever gets there first can choose the throne room, or the sewers, and we will then defeat the final boss. If we do that before this little timer reaches 21, we will win. If it reaches 21, and then we lose, unfortunately. So, how do we play? Well, easiest way to always teach is just to kind of get into it. Otherwise, sitting here talking about rules, that's boring. So what we do right off the bat is we explore if we want to. These little footsteps here, this is a free bonus you get. They're also on the dice here that you could roll, which I find right there. And what they do is they give you either 2 points of movement that you can use to move or to explore. Now, before I do that though, Carmen, what do we have to do?
Flip your evil
card.
That's
right. The very first thing, evil sinister wave. Execute an extra dungeon master phase immediately. Another dungeon master phase. Do we just flip another card then? No, actually what we do is the thing is, there are nothing to do in this at all. Okay, so that's actually 100% worthless.
And that was not good for the first turn, yeah.
Well, actually, it is good for the first turn. Because there's nothing on the board for us to have to execute. The dungeon master phase comes at the very end of my turn. There's nothing to do. All right, so what I'm going to do is if I look up here, I can see what type of room that I could explore into, which this is a monster spawn room. So what I can do is, if I wanted to, I could use my little free footsteps here to be able to move it into that room immediately and then see what kind of monster I'm going to fight. Then I can get myself prepared by rolling the dice and fight that monster. That's what I'm going to do. So let's flip that over. Let's explore that room. Let's plop it down right there. Good spot. Now we do flip over the next one. My luck it would be.
A trap!
I do immediately move into there. And now I put a trap. Okay, now we flip over the next one. Okay, so now I'm safe. Alright, so whenever a trap happens, I'm going to explain an awful lot of stuff here, guys. So I'm going to try to do this in each step, alright? First I explored, which means I flip up the next one. If it's a trap or an event, that immediately triggers as well. A trap will go next to the room. When you explore, you immediately go in, and the trap would go next to the room on any one of the three sides that are exposed. If you notice, there's no doors or nothing like that. You do not have to worry about that. It's going to block off a spot, though, in the dungeon. The trap will immediately inflict 1 point of damage. So, it immediately triggers, and I take a damage. If Carmen moves into this room, she will receive a point of damage. If I leave this room, it triggers again. Basically, every time you execute a movement action in this room now, that trap is going to trigger. If you notice, there's a potion there, and there's feet step there. That means if I roll these, and if I place them in there, I could dock them there, I will disarm that trap. But first, I've got bigger problems. Notice a little skull there? That signifies a minor monster. That means what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this die and I'm going to roll it. There's monsters on all sides of the die, and I'm going to fight. A spider. Yes. All right, so right there is his attack, which is 2. His defense is 4. I need to meet or exceed 4. The 3 dots are his experience. Oh, he's got a little thingy over there. That means we got to look over here on the card. Let's see what the spider does. Spider, what do you do? He is an animal. It says, web, heroes can't leave a room with any spiders, except for by teleportation. Well, I don't have teleportation, so I got to fight the spider. Fight the spider! That's fine. Let's do this. Alright, so what I do now is I can roll my dice and I can start preparing for the action, because I'm about to go into combat with the spider. Alright, so a sword and a shield, if you look on your player board, everybody has the exact same thing. If you use a shield and a sword together, it will count as 1 shield, 2 swords. Well, what does that matter? Well, what I do is I actually use my dice by placing them down here to show I've expended the dice, and that's what they're going to signify for me. I think that's probably what I'm going to do. But you do get one reroll. So I think I'm going to do my reroll before I decide which dice I want to keep 100%. So I want to keep those. I kind of want to keep the feat steps. And if you notice, the potion, I could try to disarm this trap as well. So that potion's a good one to keep as well. You know what? Gosh, that is so close. If I could get another shield, I could probably make this happen. Okay, so I do have an ability here to make a shield, but unfortunately, it doesn't work like that. You have to be able to dock them down. See, it shows dice. I really wish that was a shield. Let's try to get a shield. Come on, baby, shield.
Nope.
It was a sword. That sucks. Okay,
all right. Still use it to make a shield the same way, so.
I could. All right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to put these two down here because I got to fight that spider. And that would give me two swords, one shield. I need two more sword attack to be able to kill it. I'm going to have to do that. So two more swords. I still have what I need to be able to disarm the trap. I will accept the damage. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do 1, 2, 3, 4, one shield, which means that is enough to defeat him, but he is going to hit me back for one. Now, one thing you need to know is that you can use ranged attacks sometimes. And if you use a ranged attack, they don't hit you back. But if you use a melee, which means you run at him with a sword, and you chop on him, then you do take damage. He's got three dots there. That's how much experience I gained. So I get 1, 2, 3. Looky there. See that arrow? That means I just leveled up. Already my character's saying, I am not just awesome, I am super awesome. So I get to choose one of these two abilities to unlock on my character. I like gold an awful lot, so we're going to go with it. So we're going to put that back down, and we're going to choose this one right here. Now, I need to disarm this trap because I really don't need any other wounds. Oops, speaking of wounds, that spider should have hit me for one. Almost forgot. All right, so I am going to disarm this trap. That does also give me 2 experience points. So, floop, floop, 5 experience points on your first turn. Tim, you are awesome. I know. Thank you. Now, let's flip this over. And that means that's going to always stay there. It just isn't going to affect anybody anymore. All right, so that would now end my turn. So what I do is I take all 6 of my dice, I put them there, and I'll go ahead and pass them over to Carmen now. But what happens now is the Dungeon Master phase will begin. So what happens with the Dungeon Master phase is that I'll pass this over to you. That we move the monsters. Now, if there were any monsters, they would move one space closer to the heroes. There are no monsters on the board, so we don't have to worry about that. The next thing that would happen, notice the spawn token here that we have there. Monsters would spawn on empty tiles. So no monsters, no heroes on it. If that was the case, so like if he was over here with Carmen, a monster now would spawn here. Well, that's not going to happen because there's no monsters there. That's basically it. That's the evil guy's face. So now it goes over to Carmen. Now, last thing, I'm sorry, I almost forgot. This will move forward one space. So now we've got, one less turn to be able to do something with. So, and I did defeat the spider, so I do get another treasure card too. So you get a treasure card and you get the experience. Almost forgot. All right, Carmen, your turn.
Okay, to start off my turn, I get to my evil card. Unnatural speed. All monsters have +1 move point during the Dungeon Master phase this turn. We don't have any monsters out, so...
Yeah.
Don't think that's going to affect us.
Yeah, I like that.
I will use my footy footsteps.
My footy footsteps. You going to explore?
I'm going to explore.
All right, so Carmen's going to explore a treasure room. So let's... Do you know how to explain that, or do you need me to help you out?
I'm going to put the treasure room here, and the way this works is it's going to get a coin in the middle of the room. Now, if I dock a sword here, I will get 1 experience point and 1 coin. So that's how that will work.
Mm-hmm. What else is happening in this room?
Now a monster!
That's right, the little skull. The skull means that it's a minor monster, and you got yourself a skeleton. Let's look on your
skeleton.
Card. What do skeletons do?
A skeleton is an undead monster. It is immune to damage from the ranged attack symbols, but potions can be used as ranged attacks against the monster.
Now you've got a special ability against undead.
I do. Valerie has a starting ability that combat with undead monsters is optional, so I don't even have to fight him if I don't want to. I could just leave. While in a room with any undead monsters, gain 1 shield. So right now, I have a shield, and I could go ahead and use my second movement and explore again if I wanted to.
Yeah, because you don't have to stay
because
in there.
Because I don't have to stay in there and fight the monster.
That's right.
I think I will do that.
Where are you going to head to this time?
Well, this room right here.
All right, something popped up. So where are you going to place that? You want to go here, here, here?
I think here.
All right, so you're coming more towards me, so I'm going to slide this down a little bit. Okay. Now, you did get a curse. Lose one action die and discard this room. Now, we flip up the next one. Okay, and you're safe there.
I lose an action die. That stinks. Okay.
You immediately go into here.
Yep.
And we immediately roll another minor monster. All right, so this guy, let's check it out, and let's look at your thing. What does he do? He's the cultist.
The cultist. Start of combat, steals one magic die, if available. If not, steals one magic symbol.
Well, that's not a magic. That's actually a potion.
Potion.
Yes.
Potion.
Yeah. Magic would be something a little different. But Yeah. Great. So anyways, so now she knows when she rolls her dice that she has to...
Is that the magic?
That would be magic,
okay,
yes.
Okay, sorry.
So now she knows not to have any of them potions.
Yeah, I don't want potions because they'll just be stolen.
All right. So you get one reroll. And you do have enough to kill him with your range, your bow and arrow.
That's nice.
Yes.
What do I want to reroll? I might want to reroll these two.
Okay. And, okay, so he is going to steal that.
He's going to steal
so
that.
So you lost your potion.
That stinks.
Yeah.
Okay.
Good part is, though, you got enough to kill him. The bad part is you're not going to be able to do anything else.
Yeah. So I will use these to kill him.
Okay. And then, if you look... He gives you 2 experience points, and you're going to get another card. So I'll move you up 2 experience. Okay.
Then these are left over. Now...
You do have feet steps with your
thing. I do. I could use this treasure card and move back into that room and fight that monster.
Yeah, you could. You could kill him.
But I wouldn't have any shields, so...
Technically, you would. You've got 1 shield automatically because he's undead.
1 shield, yeah. I don't know. I
think it's a good idea.
Point?
Why not? Let's get rid of him.
I know I could have done that before, right? No, then I wouldn't have lost my movement. So,
right.
Okay.
It's up to you. Or, the other thing she can do is she can collect a bounty, which means that she just doesn't do anything, and she'll get 1 gold coin for each die that she doesn't use.
Well, I don't know. We're in a hurry, so I guess I'll do it. I'll use that to move in here and fight him with my 2 swords and 1 shield.
Which kills him, but now he will do 1 damage back to you.
Yep.
Okay, and you did get 2 more experience, which means now you just leveled up, and you get another card.
Sweet.
So now you go ahead and level up your character.
Ooh, that's a nice card.
What is it? Oh, is that the one with the negative defense one? I like that one.
I keep getting a glare on the camera. So I get to level up. I'm going to go with this one. I already know what my cards are. Again, this one's going to help me fight monsters and get more potions. This one's good, but for now, I want more fighting power.
Okay. So now what we're going to do is we're going to go into the dungeon phase, which means go ahead and pass me the camera, go ahead and get me the dice, and now what we're going to do first, right off the bat, is we are going to move any monsters on the board. There are no monsters to move. Next, we are going to spawn, I'm sorry, the very first thing is we spawn the monsters.
Uh-huh.
I'm sorry. So, no, I'm sorry, we do move them, and then we spawn them. I'm sorry,
okay.
I had to look over here and it confused me based upon what I saw, but I thought I was right. So what we do now is we spawn.
So I did fight him for no reason.
No, not necessarily.
Because
he would not have
spawned.
But he would have moved into your room.
Yeah.
Right. Because he would have moved, and then one would have... No, nothing would have spawned here.
Yeah,
you're absolutely
so...
right. So we do have one that did pop up, though. Now we do move this. So we're on number 3. And then it basically just goes into my turn. So, all right. Let's see what happens with my evil card. Let's go ahead and flip it up. Deadly Aura. If any hero ends his turn in the same room as another hero, each hero in that room takes 2 wounds. That's no big deal. Go ahead and just put that up there if you wouldn't mind, please. All right, so what I'm going to do, let's explore. So I will flip that over. I'm going to take this one, and I'm going to head down towards Carmen area.
Treasure room.
And go ahead and put that there. We will spawn a monster. Monster. Go ahead and flip up that tile if you wouldn't mind, please. All right, it's another monster room. All right, so we know what he does, the cultist. It says here, remember, he steals, he'll steal a potion.
Die.
So we don't want potions. So I do move in there. I do have 1 more point of exploring.
You're top heavy.
I am top heavy. I do have 1 more point of movement, but unfortunately combat happens, so I lose my other point of movement. That's all right. All right, let's see what happens here. Let's kill this dude. All right, so he will steal that potion, so we don't necessarily want that. However, we do have 2 wounds, so he's only going to steal 1 of them. Maybe it's a good idea to possibly just have enough of them to where let him steal it. But I also do have these down here that could heal me. So I don't know. I'm not too worried about those. So I'm going to probably reroll those. And I'm going to keep 1 foot because of that. I'm going to keep both the feet, actually. And I'm going to keep the shield. I think I'll just reroll this. And I got another potion. My goodness. Well, that's not very good, actually. So the problem with this is that I needed at least one sword to be able to hit him with, and I did not roll any. I've got one here, but I needed a sword on a here, and I didn't get that, which really stinks. So what this means is I'm not going to be able to defeat him. Now, he will hit me for 2, so what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to put 1 potion here, and that's going to give me a shield and a gold. Go ahead and give me that. Okay. Next, I'm going to use another shield just to... Nope, I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to take the 1 wound. So that's all I'm going to do. I'll take the 1 wound. Now that combat's done, I have the option now. I can leave this room. I don't have to stay there now. And I can do other things like heal and stuff like that. The other thing I can do is I can go ahead and do this thing here. That's why I didn't want to spend this other one. So I am going to, which, yeah, thank you. I appreciate that. So I'm glad you did steal that for me. Thank you. I'll just put it down there as a spent one. So I am going to place this right there, which will then give me this treasure and 1 experience point. So I'll move myself up 1 experience point. I was really hoping to be able to hit my next one right there. Okay. Now, what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to leave this room by spending this for movement. And I will explore... And I think I'll go right here. So go ahead and place it there. And let's flip up this one. Ah, look at that. Place a shield there and you get 2 heals. All right. So that will move me automatically into here. So we do spawn another monster. And that is, not good, actually. Okay, so that's Ghoul, and Ghouls just want to have fun. Start a combat, steals 1 foot symbol if available. If not, steals 1 foot symbol if possible, even possibly the free one. This ain't good because I was planning on using my foot symbol for that, and now he stole it from me. Why are these guys stealing all my stuff, man? So he stole that, and the even worse problem is that I think I just may have died. Thank goodness I have this! Because I would have just died. My God, that was stupid of me. Okay, so I should have healed before I came in here, but that's okay. So what's going to happen is I am going to use this to shield up, and I'm going to use these 2 shields in this combat. I cannot hit him. I turn on the camera, and I just forget everything.
Does he hit you for 1?
He's going to still hit me for 1, yeah. See, he's got the 3 damage right there, so he's still going to hit me for 1, so that's going to move this down. So now what I'm going to have to do is, now that combat's done, I'm going to have to use this to heal 1. And then, in fact, you know what? I'm not going to use that to heal 1. Fully heal a hero in your room or adjacent room. I'm just going to use this to heal fully. And then I'm going to use this right here to just gain another gold coin. And then I'll just dock, you know, not do anything with it. Basically, it's called turning a bounty. So that'll give me 3 coins now. All right. So that was a really lousy turn for me, unfortunately. Now we're going to go into the dungeon master phase. So let's go ahead and pass this over to Carmen. Let's give her all of these dice. Okay. All right. So very first thing that happens is that you're going to move the monsters. So basically, they just go towards the nearest hero. Now, we have the option. We can move them because it's kind of evenly split here.
Okay.
We can move them to you, or they can come to me.
Well, I'll take the undead one.
Okay.
Definitely.
So...
Might as well take both of them.
You sure? I think you could probably beat them both, to be honest with you.
Probably.
Okay, now what happens is we do spawn 1 here, because it's an empty room, and that's a spider. All right, now we're going to move this little marker, and, thank you, we do have 1 there. And another spider, my God.
Okay.
Woo, that's a lot of monsters, I don't think we've ever had this many. All right, Carmen, you are up to bat. What you gonna do? What you gonna do when the monsters come for you? Evil card. Evil card.
Tough healing. Any player must pay 1 gold. For each wound, the active hero heals this turn. Oh, that's not good.
That would have been bad on my turn.
I don't have gold.
Yeah.
Okay.
I've got gold, though.
Well, I guess I'll roll the dice and see what happens and try to fight some of these monsters.
Yeah, you got plenty of them. So, so real quick. This guy here, what is he? He's the orc. He has no special abilities. This guy is going to steal a potion. So you don't want any potion dice, so keep that in mind.
Okay. Question. What's the deal with that?
You explore it, and then if you go into there, you're going to dock a shield die there, and that's going to give you two healings.
Would I get
healings.
To move again after, because it wouldn't be combat?
Technically, no, because you would be stopping to do this action. Okay. So I think no matter what, anytime you interrupt your movement action, you don't get the second movement. All
points. Right. Well, let's see what happens.
Now, I could be wrong on that, but that's a good question. All right, so that's a lot of feet. Feet.
I don't need feet. Look, feet are useless. I have no use for feet.
I have no use for you feet.
So, I'll reroll all the feet.
Mm-hmm. I'll move these up here some. Go ahead. Okay, let's just
and throw the tear
everything.
Up the board. Okay. Well, there we go. So, I lose this to the monster.
Yep. Well, it's pretty down there.
That's
okay.
What I'm left with. Let's see, they both have two.
Yeah, they both have two defense. So technically you're going to be able to defeat both of them.
I will take these, put them down there. That gives me two swords and a shield.
Mm-hmm.
So I will use those to go up against this guy. He's dead, and he hits me back for two, which I blocked. Okay?
You blocked both of them?
Yes, because I have
is
an extra
Is he undead?
Shield.
Oh, how do you get the extra one?
Well, in a room with an undead monster, gain a shield.
I don't believe either one of those are undead. Neither one of those are undead. Look on your player board.
Oh, is that a goblin?
That's... Look right here. That's a cultist and an orc. Notice undead will be specifically marked. So skeleton
that
and
was
ghoul.
An
maybe.
Undead.
Nope.
Shoot.
So that's not an undead, so you might want to... I'll put that back there. Is that what you still want to do? Because if you look down here, Carmen, look at your cards, your treasure cards, hon.
I mean, it doesn't matter.
Right. It doesn't matter. You're absolutely right, actually. But you do want to use your bow and arrow treasure card with this bow and arrow to be able to kill the orc with, so he does not hit you back.
They only take two.
He takes three.
No, he hits me back for three, but he only takes two.
Oh,
hits.
So I'm sorry. I thought that,
yeah.
Never mind. Okay, so you're going to take one wound for killing him.
I'll take one wound for killing him.
So we'll leave him right there.
All
right. Okay.
And then I'll use this.
Yeah.
And we will use that to kill that guy. That way he's not going to hit me back.
He will not hit back at all. Okay, so you gained a total of 4 experience points for killing all of those. So 1, 2, 3, 4, which means you did level up again.
Yay!
And you get 2 more treasure cards.
Sweet. These are some good treasures. This glare is terrible. All right. Now I could... unlock that treasure.
Would you have to put a sword there? I'd do it, absolutely.
Yeah, I guess.
Well, I see what you're thinking. You're thinking you might still be able to...
I'm thinking that if I explore again...
Well, when you explore, you're going to go into this room right here. With
exactly,
the...
but I don't have to stop there. I could explore again and again. So, that's a thought. Let's explore.
Okay. So the next one will turn up, and it's a teleportation room.
Okay. And that is that only one movement? Or is that two?
That would consist of one, so you used your feet for that. You need to go ahead and put your... Or are you using those? Okay.
I'll use these.
I want to make sure.
Okay.
Okay, so now you could actually do this again if you like.
But that would use this?
No.
No.
No, no. It would be your second point of movement with your token that you're tied.
Let's do it then.
Okay, so where do you want to put it? Don't
there.
Get too far away from me. There you go. Okay, now let's flip over your next tile, and it is a trap. So
it's a trap.
Let's put the trap, say, right here. You will take one wound for the trap.
Okay.
And then if you look at the next one, what do we got? It's your staircase to the second level.
Yes.
Very good. Okay,
sweet.
So we do spawn a minor monster in there. And it is another spider. Unfortunately, it means you're not going to be able to defeat him. So, I don't think you have anything or enough of. You just need to make sure you try to shield up if you can.
Choose a monster. It has -2 defense this turn.
Oh, fantastic.
Haha. So.
Nope, we won't put it there. We'll put it up here. That's okay.
Let's see. I will use this.
Mm-hmm. Now, you can't heal, unfortunately, I don't think. Because remember it said any player must pay 1 gold for each wound at the active hero here. Any player, yes, I could pay the gold to be able to let you heal, yes. So,
let's see, what's he hit me
with? He will hit you with 2.
He's gonna hit me with 2?
Yeah.
I don't have any.
No, you have shields. No shields.
But I'm not gonna be able to kill him.
Yeah, and that's anyway. Okay. I'll pay the gold so that you can activate your potion.
Okay.
And then he is dead.
But he hits me, right?
Yeah. So,
for
basically,
2?
No, he hits you for just... Yeah, he hits you for 2 back, yes, and then you should have healed the 1, so
yeah,
you're at 2 health then?
Yeah, I'm not doing too hot.
Nope, not at all. So you did gain 3 experience. Now, the thing about this is, though, is that because she has reached level 7, you want to bring the camera up here?
Mm-hmm.
Because she has reached level 7, she gets -1 experience for the easier one, so she only gets 2 experience instead of 3. Yet you still get a treasure card. Okay.
I don't think that's me. We messed something up. I don't have... I should have leveled up twice if that was me.
Yeah, you should have leveled up a second time. Did you not do it? Nope, you didn't. So you should have probably been able to... There you go. We'll just push that up there. No biggie.
Okay. Choose one room. Any monsters in this room do not move. Choose one room. Ignore the dungeon master phase. That's nice.
Okay.
All right. What am I going to do with these?
Well,
get money for them?
Yeah, probably.
I don't have anything else to do with them. I mean, I could explore the staircase, right, and plop it on.
Well, I think what we're... Yeah. I would probably just... you probably could if you wanted to. I would probably just collect the money, and then I'll head your direction, and we'll probably leave together. Unless you want to. You can do that.
Okay, I'll collect
the money. You want to go ahead and explore? It's up to you. It's no big deal.
I don't know. I mean, we're on a timer, but at the same time, I'm almost dead. So, you know.
Yeah, that's why I just don't want you to get too far away from me.
To collect the money.
Yeah. Because you could probably walk back up here even if you wanted to, heal up, and then put the staircase over here instead. And then that way you could try to get those 2 potions to heal. So, all right.
Okay.
So, we're going to go into the Dungeon Master phase. So, go ahead and give me the camera. Go ahead and give me all the dice. You don't seem happy with that decision. You seem like you wanted to explore.
No, I'm just confused about the experience points.
No, you're good on the experience points. You've killed an awful lot of monsters. You're fine. We just forgot to level you up when you got to theirs, so that's no big deal. So we will move that up while we're thinking about it, though. The monsters will move. So why don't we move this spider into your room, and we'll move this spider down to there. Now we will spawn a monster here and here. So we'll put one there, and God, I have got to hack through an awful lot of garbage to get to you. Goodness, not good at all. Now keep in mind, Carmen, this trap is going to trigger if you try to move out of here. So that's something important to remember for you. All right, so we did everything, right? We moved him, we spawned him, now it's my turn. So let's go ahead and grab the camera, and let's go ahead and see what my evil card is. Evil card, what are you? Please don't be too evil. Bleed. Any hero must pay 1 gold, or the active hero takes 1 wound for each room he moves into this turn. All right, so basically, as I move, I have to pay a gold, so that really does kind of stink.
Any player must pay 1 gold, or the active hero.
I will just pay the 1 gold.
Yeah, I think it's just 1 gold now.
Right,
yeah.
You're
okay.
Right. Okay, so let's check everything out. The ghoul, what does he do? If I remember, he steals my feet. Oh, I hate that so much. Do not like that at all. So I'm going to keep both those feet. Feet. Yeah, that's not a terrible roll. I think I'll re-roll that. And the potion. Okay. Well, you're about to see how magic symbols work.
Mm.
Yeah, so I lose the foot, so we'll just take this away. Actually, we'll do this, because the ghoul took that, because we're about to start a combat immediately. So, all right, so we need to kill him. He's got 3 health, and... I hate him. So let's put this up here. That's going to give me 1 sword attack and 2 gold coins. Can you give me 2 gold coins, please? Thank you, sweetie. All right. Next, we will put a sword and a shield down here. So that would give me enough to kill him, but he's going to hit me. So I think we're going to put another shield here, and then we'll get another coin for that as well. Thank you. All right. So that's one, two, three, and two shields. So unfortunately, he will still hit me for one, and we'll just take that. Okay, so that will let me level up three. So, one, two, three. If you notice, I passed that, so that does mean I'm going to level up my character guy, and I do get another treasure card. Ooh, that's actually a really good one. Let's see what we got here. So, I can do that one, or, better yet, we're going to do this one. Because... No, you're fine, you're fine. I got it. Don't worry, sweetie. Thank you. All right, for three gold, I get three swords and a shield. And notice the little circle? That means nice. I can do that as much as I'd like. So if I can get two more gold, I can do 6 points of damage in one turn. So, all right, these are my last two dice. Why did I put that there? That was stupid of me. I meant to put that there. Why would I put a shield there?
Yeah.
That was really dumb. I wasn't thinking. Okay. So anyways, that's all I've got, though, at the moment. But I did get some bows and arrows.
Nice.
Let's put that back down. And I do have the capacity to use that. So what I want to do now is I want to move it. So let's move. And we're going to move into this room with this guy. I'm thinking he will hit me pretty good, but I will be able to kill him. And let's just do it. Yeah, yeah, yeah. He won't hit me that much. Okay, so he will steal any feet that I have. I don't have any more feet because I used all my feet dice and I used all my foot symbols. So he will not be able to hurt me. So let's just put this token down here. I'm going to use one shield. I'm going to activate my critical swing. So I get three swords, two shields. And that'll be enough to kill him, but he will hit me for one again. So I go down one. That will, though, give me another treasure card and 2 points of experience. One, two. Oh, nice. Yes, delicious. All right, so that would pretty much end my turn for the most part. I really don't have any movement or anything like that. The only thing I hate is that I did not get close enough to Carmen so that I could try to heal her because she's so busted up over there with only two health. It's got me a little nervous, to be honest with you. I was hoping I could make it over there.
I've got a greater heal card.
Yeah, I know, but still... Don't forget about this. If you try to move out, that thing's going to trigger and get you, okay? That's important. Okay, so that would end my turn. Let's pass it over to Carmen. By the way, if one of us dies, we do lose. So this is really critical. All right, so what we're going to do, pass the camera over to Carmen. I'm going to pass all the dice over to her. We're going to go into the Dungeon Master's phase. So what I'm going to do, because this spider, first it would move. So it could go here or here. If I move it here, it blocks that spawning point. So duh, I'm going to block the spawn point. He'll move down, does open up that one, so we'll put another monster there.
Do we need to get rid of all the monsters or anything before we can move out, or is it...
No, we can go. Big deal. Okay, now we will increase this. Now, Carmen, let's go ahead and flip and see what your evil card is. Oh, it's the same thing, ain't it?
Any player must pay one gold, or the active hero takes one wound for each room he moves into this turn.
Why don't you pay the gold this time so that I can make sure I get my critical swing. Next turn.
Now let's see. I should just go ahead and use this.
You can't, unfortunately.
Can't?
You are in a combat already, which means you are actually, you can't do anything until you fight the spider once. So
okay.
He only hits for two. That's the good thing. So it's not like he hits you for a lot, but still, unfortunately, yeah, you're stuck there at the moment.
So, I guess I'm gonna have to roll my dice.
Mm-hmm.
I could ignore any payback on the first attack you make this turn, I could use that because, I'll die if he hits me for two, but I'll roll the dice and we'll see what I get.
All right. Okay. Now you get one reroll.
I got no shields. That's not good.
No, but you keep
this.
Oh,
wait, but I did get the, what, no, that's not going to help me.
Keep this just in case. Yes, it will help. Well... I can give you one bow. I can give you one arrow symbol. Just so you know.
I will reroll that, definitely.
This could at least make sure you get a shield by using that. I just wanted to make sure you thought about that.
Okay.
You're making me nervous. You gotta remember, if you move out of this room, this trap triggers too. So if you don't put a potion and that on there, you see what I'm saying?
Then I should put my potion back down. There we go.
There you go.
Row.
Roll
okay. that one. Roll that beautiful bean footage. That's not good. Okay, ignore any payback on the first attack when you make this turn.
So at least he can't hurt you now.
He cannot hurt me. Wah-ha-ha.
You can't hurt me now.
I gotta hit him for 4. Wow, okay. So then that goes there. That hits him for 2. These are going to go down here, hit him for 2 more.
Yes, and see what Carmen did? She actually did combine arrow attack with a melee attack. Mm-hmm. But unfortunately, that does mean that he still will fight back. But thank goodness she had her card, so he will not hurt her. So, and then, yes, that'll heal you once. So, all right, so you killed the spider, so you do get a treasure card. Yay. And you gain 2 points of experience with, if you look, this time I'll make sure I remind you, you did level up. So go ahead and level up.
I like leveling up.
Mm-hmm.
And this is really good, but this is really good too. Look at that. Oh.
I would go with that one as well. I do like that an awful lot. Okay.
So now I need to disarm that trap.
Yeah, so you'll have to use your magic.
We'll use the magic. And now all 3 of these, well, actually these will go.
Yeah, and then that'll give you 2 more points of experience.
Yay.
Uh-huh, and then we'll flip that over.
Okay.
And you haven't used your foot token yet,
right?
I
haven't used my foot token yet. I can get the staircase put out there if that's a good
idea. Well, right here. Why don't you move here and then explore there? And then that'll put it right next to me.
Because that's 2 movement points?
Uh-huh. So then that'll put it right here. Now, let's make sure we'll flip over the next tile. Nothing's going to harm us. We never run into a medium room this whole time. That's actually
funny.
Oh,
that's weird.
And you'll immediately go to there, which means now Carmen has the capacity to explore the level 2 tiles. So, all right, that will pretty much end her turn. So now we're going to go into the Dungeon Master's phase. We'll move this down to number 7. So we are going to move the monsters. We will spawn. Thank you. We will spawn 1 monster right up here, which isn't really going to matter because we're both about to leave this chamber anyways. And level 1 monsters don't move to level 2, so it's not going
to
matter.
I forgot to use my healing.
Oh, did you? Well, go ahead and use your healing now. I think that we all expected you probably were going to.
Yeah.
So that'll heal you completely, right?
Yes.
Okay, very good. All right, so now it will go into my turn. So let's see what my eval card will be. So let's flip this over.
You know what? I'm going to use this one instead.
Which one? Okay, so Carmen's debating on which treasure card to use. So,
yeah.
Monster Ambush. Any player must pay 3 gold or a major monster immediately spawns in the same room as the active hero.
Crap. And we only have 3 gold.
Nope. So, nice. Great. I get to fight a major monster now. Sheesh. And it's this thingy, and he is pretty tough, so let's see what he does. A young dragon ignores the first arrow, so... shoot, he's a 4 and a 4, plus I've already got a spider in here. That's a 2 and a 4. Crap! Sucks to be me. Good thing I got my critical swing going here. Swing! The bad part is, if I don't roll enough shields, holy crap, their combined attack could very well kill me. Well, let's see what we get here, guys. So we need some shields. Alright, so let's see. And I rolled no shields, so that's fantastic. Because that's what I needed, was no shields. Let's keep 1 foot token. Let's keep this. And I don't really need this, so I'm just going to reroll all... Should I keep the other sword? I don't know if I need to. Yeah, keep the other sword. Let's roll these 2. Ugh, at least I got 1, I guess. Okay. Well, hopefully I don't freaking die here. Okay, so I will fight the dragon first. And, you'll see exactly why I'm going to do that. Yeah, this will actually be okay, I think. Yep, okay. We're okay!
Hmm.
Alright, so what we're going to do is we are going to fight the dragon first. Fight the dragon! And we're going to put this right here. That'll give me 1 sword and 2 money, so 2 money, please. In fact, just keep it. Here's my 3rd money. And that is enough now to do my critical swing. So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4... 1 shield, okay?
I would have used my footsteps for that.
Well, it was supposed to be footsteps.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you.
There you go.
Okay, so anyways, so that's 4, and then one. So I'm going to take three damage if I don't try to do a little bit of something more here. So what I'm thinking about doing is, and I know this is probably going to sound funny, but I am going to put a sword right here. That's going to give me a shield and a gold coin. Okay. Now I'm going to use my other shield down here. So that gives me three shields and four sword attack. So that will be enough to kill the dragon. That will give me now four experience, but we'll do that. Oh my god, I totally forgot. I don't get that immediately. Crap.
Oh, that's why you went for the dragon?
Yeah, because I forgot. You don't get your experience right until all combat's over. But that's okay. It's all right. I'm not going to panic. Shoot, that does stink though. Now he does hit me for one, so we'll just go down one. All right, he is dead. Which, crap, I don't know why I forgot that. So now I got to fight the spider. So he's only going to hit back for two. So no matter what, he can't kill me. But I got to get through his four attack. Dang, that was stupid of me. And I don't have any movement at all. I didn't use this. There,
yeah,
so I will be able to move.
You never
used
that.
So I'm okay. So what I can do with the spider is that I'm going to use this magic symbol to change this into an arrow. I'm going to combine it with this card here. That's four arrows, and now I get no hit back. So that's a total of 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 experience. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I leveled up twice in just that one action. So that's pretty sweet. So basically, there we go. I am as powerful as I can get now. All right, so these two guys are gone. That does give me two more treasure cards, though. Oh, man. Oh, that was a lot. Now I will use my feet, and I'll move to here. Now, if I wanted to, which this actually should be revealed, I could move into there. It's just a minor monster, and I technically have the capacity to heal. And I'm kind of thinking, why not? Let's just do this. So let's go ahead and explore with my second point of movement. And no, these monsters cannot move into here. So don't worry about that.
Trap.
Oh, stupid. So, stupid trap. Dang it. So what we need to do is actually just clear all of this. So go ahead and just clear off all of them. And let's get this set up and for the second level here. Because these monsters are not going to move down. They don't really have the capacity to catch us. So, let's get those all off of there. We'll move this to here. We'll put the trap right here, which does immediately trigger, so I do take a wound. Which means I technically should have healed before. I'm going to heal. I'm going to cheat a little bit, sorry. I would have done that if I didn't have the camera on, because I knew that I was going to go up against the monster in here. Okay, so, anyways. So now I will have to put a gold token on there. I will have to roll for a minor monster. And he goes right there. Okay. And now I've got to deal with this stupid trap and all this stuff. So let's see. This is everything I've already spent. So technically I don't have any dice left. So we'll put that up over there. But I can kill some crap because I've got enough swords here. So I don't see a reason why not. At the start of the combat, he would steal a healing potion. I don't have any. I don't have any way to really heal, to be honest. So I don't see any reason why not. Let's just use our three swords. We will kill him. He will hit me back for two, which he was going to do anyways. 1, 2. That will give me one more point of experience, and it will give me another treasure card. Okay. That goes away. And then that would be it for me. Wow, that was an awfully long turn.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so this can go away as well, so we don't need that anymore. Thank you. And we are in the second dungeon, so we need what? We need a magic and a potion to disarm that, which it's going to affect you as soon as you move in as well, but I guess you could go this direction. So, all right, let's do the dungeon master phase. Let's give that over to you. Let's give you all of the dice. Okay, and we need to advance this one space. And we now need to spawn monsters, move monsters. That's not going to happen. So, Carmen, evil phase.
Evil. Amnesia. The first time the active hero uses each of their abilities this turn, any player must pay one additional gold.
What is it again?
I'm going to forget all of my abilities. That's
all
nice.
Of them? So, okay. I guess we'll just have to cancel that evil card. How's
ha,
that?
Ah, ah.
There you go. Never
Thank
mind.
You. Okay. So let's see what this is.
Okay.
So
So we'll flip the next one. All right. So you will get another minor monster, which is a ghoul and a gold coin on there. Okay, go ahead.
All right. I'm not going to have used my movement token.
Okay. Now the ghoul, he will steal a foot symbol. So the good thing is you've already used your foot symbol.
So I might want to re-roll this one, though.
Yeah.
Let's see. I will keep... Wait, what am I doing? I'm confused.
Mm.
So I'll re-roll all this. I'll just keep those two.
There you go.
Look at all those shields. Oh
yeah, but
goodness.
That's good. I think you actually use shields, don't you?
No.
No, you don't.
I don't. I use swords.
Well, succotash. Well, the good part is he is undead.
He's undead, so I don't even have to fight him.
No, but you also could unlock this little thingy here, too, with all them shields.
Let's unlock the thingy.
So you're not going to fight him, then?
There's no point to fighting him.
Yeah, you can't kill him, can you?
No.
So you have the option of just ignoring him.
Yeah.
So, and then that gives you also an experience.
Yay.
So there you go. Now you don't have any movement either. That's the bad part.
Let's put this down here.
I'll let you heal one and you get two gold. Okay.
Oops. I'm having trouble with the camera. Okay. I guess we'll get four more gold. I mean, what else am I going to do?
Unfortunately, you can only hold two more gold.
Yep. Honestly, I can't. I
don't know. No, that was actually a very, very, very bad round for you. So, yeah. Unfortunately. Okay, so let's go ahead and give you...
Can I spend my gold now?
You can spend it as you get it. Yes. So, what you can do is you could say you get one. Now, spend all five. And she could buy a treasure card because they're five coins apiece.
Treasure card.
And then one, two, three. There you go.
Sparkle, sparkle.
Okay. All right. So that's the end of your turn, right? Okay. So go ahead and pass the camera over. Let's go ahead and advance the timer. And now monsters spawn, monsters move. Nothing's going to happen. All right. Let's see what my evil card is. So we'll flip this over. It's a trap. All armed traps immediately activate. Also, you must dock one additional die of any kind to disarm. Holy crap. Man, I'm so glad that I used my ignore the evil card for you that you didn't even use and I got totally hosed. So that cost Carmen, look, I'm about to die.
I can give you right now 2 health points.
Yes, we should do that. So go ahead and do that. Give me 2. All right. Now let's go ahead and roll the dice. Okay. Let's see. What do I need? You have to just dock an additional, so I need a health potion and a magic. So I'm going to just reroll all of these. Okay. So I got what I needed. Okay, there we go. Alright, so a health potion and a magic to disarm, but unfortunately I have to dock an additional one.
Mm-hmm.
There we go. So I will just dock, I guess, this. Yeah, I'll just do this. So, all right, unfortunately. So, that does flip that over, and that does give me 3 experience points, I guess. But whoop-de-doo, right?
You don't get anything for them.
No, not really. Okay. All right, well, I'll start heading your way. So, let's explore. Oh, God. I don't have any more health or nothing, man. It's so scary, to be honest. I'm scared.
Mm-hmm.
So, he's got what, just 3 health? Hmm. I could kill him.
He attacks back for 3, though.
Yeah, I know. That's the problem. You don't have any other healing spells or nothing?
Uh-uh.
Mm-mm. Yeah, I'm in trouble because I don't have any healing spells is the problem. I don't have nothing that's healing me at all. Shoot. I could come down and kill him, but he would hit me for at least 2.
Well, I could use the experience anyway.
Yeah, I guess. I don't know. What do you think? I mean, should I just come down and kill him so that you can explore?
No.
No? Well, I mean, it's not good for me to explore there. That's a major monster room for me. I mean, if I stop, I might as well just collect 3 coins, I guess, and for my dice. because I don't think it's a good idea for me to do anything else.
It's kind of good for you to have 3 coins.
I understand that, but I can get it very easily with this anyways, is what I'm trying to explain. So, I don't know. Because, see, I could put one there, put one there. That'll give me 1, 2 coins. That's enough. Which means then... I'm coming. Man, I am so smart. Okay, so we're going to move. 1. We're going to move 2. Rawr! He will steal a foot token. I don't have any foot tokens, so it doesn't matter. So here's what we're going to do. We are going to dock this here.
Yep.
That gives me 1, 2, and a shield. Also a coin. Now, mm-hmm. We are going to dock this right here. That gives me a shield and a coin. And now we're going to use all 3 of those.
There you go.
And that gives me 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 swords and 1, 2, 3 shields. And that's enough to hit him.
Bye-bye.
Kill him. And he doesn't hit me back at all. So that will 1, 2. So actually, 2. So that killed him. And that will get me another treasure card, which is good. Okay. Wow, that was so cool. And I do have this left over, so that will still give me a coin. All right. So let's go into the dungeon phase. So we'll pass the camera over to you. Let's get you all the dice. Let's advance the marker. There are no monsters to spawn, and there are no monsters to move. So, evil phase.
Clumsy. Any player must pay 1 gold for each arrow die the active hero uses this turn.
Oh, okay.
I don't usually use those anyway, so...
Yeah, I'm worried. I'm shaking in my baby seal skin boots.
All right, let's use this. Boom, boom, boom.
Okay, which way you want to go?
I don't know. Just here's fine, I guess. Okay. It doesn't matter.
Right? All right, that's a major monster.
Major monster.
And
what
you've
is it?
Got... It's like a pig guy. Let's look on your board.
A pig guy. Spear Beastman? Is that who that is?
The very top one. Yep.
Maybe killed with 3 magic symbols.
Yep.
Oh, nice.
Which is good, because you got 2 magic symbols already.
Does he still going to do his payback if I kill him?
No, because magic would count as a ranged attack.
Okay.
It's a spell attack. Attack spell, I'm sorry.
I didn't roll.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
So,
I rolled a magic.
Real
yeah.
quick,
okay.
One thing is we forgot to flip over.
Oh, no.
Poisonous gas. Take 1 wound and discard this room. So you do take a wound. And now we flip your next one. Oh, boy.
Uh-oh.
This could be bad. That will be a level 2 big room. We don't know what that is yet.
Okay.
So you need your magic symbol.
I definitely need my magic symbol. The arrows, I don't think I want. I guess I'll keep a shield and a foot, and we'll reboot this.
Ooh, keep your potion for sure.
Okay, well, it's too late now. I have to keep everything. Mm-hmm. All right, so I'm going to combine that with this card and kill him.
And that does give you 3. You get a treasure card and 3 experience. 1, 2, 3,
yay!
Which means you did level up the last portion
finally,
of your figure.
Finally,
so,
I've been waiting for that.
There you go.
Okay. That's a pretty good one. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Now,
that's a major monster room. It's a major, it's a big, it's a medium room is what it's called.
I have footsteps, so.
You gonna do it?
Hold on, let me think. Should I use something first? It doesn't matter, right?
You could heal first if you
yeah.
wanted to, but you could actually do that right here, so. Which is good, actually, yeah. And that'll get you 2 coins as well. There you
okay.
go.
And we'll use the footsteps.
Here we go. All right, so this what we do now is
mm-hmm.
we are going to draw from this. Here, I'll let you pick which one you want.
Let's go with the top one.
All right.
Bum, bum, bum.
Ooh, it's the snake. Sneaky snake, gone dancing. All right, so we'll put 2 coins
the
here.
Hydra, is that what he's called?
And now you have to fight this snake. And you fight him twice. Alright, so let's look it up with the snake real fast, because I can never remember what these guys do. I know we fought him once before. She will have to defeat both sides of him, though. So, his blue side, payback 4, defense 3, dead dread aura, magic symbols can't be used in the room where the Hydra is. So, you can't use any magic symbols.
Okay. Wow. He's got a payback of 4.
Yeah.
That's kind of scary.
That's
okay.
why I was telling you. I was worried.
I don't think I have any way of killing him, to be honest. Let's see, he's got three. Yes, I do. I do have a way of killing him. Okay. Choose a monster. It has negative two defense this turn.
So he's only got one defense then? So he's only going to have a one. You only have to hit him with like one sword or one arrow. So if you hit him with the arrow, then he won't hit you back at all.
Okay, so I'll pay one gold and use my arrow.
Yes, because you're clumsy. Uh-huh.
Okay. And then...
Well, that's it. Wait a minute.
He doesn't hit me back.
No, he won't. So now that will give you three experience. So one, two, three. Now what happens is he flips over.
Mm-hmm.
And now he's more angry. So it says here, two shall take its place. If the Hydra is not killed with swords only, it goes back to the blue side. So you have to kill it with a sword attack.
I have to kill it with swords now.
So the good part is I can help you with that, though. I can help by playing this, and I'll give you two swords myself.
He's got a defense of four.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, well, I already used this on him last time, and I didn't discard it. So so then I will put this...
Yep.
Wait. I'll put it down here so it gives me a shield.
Yeah, that's probably a better idea. Okay.
So that'll give me two swords and a shield. That'll give me four swords and... Mm-hmm. A shield.
One
shield.
That's it. One shield. So now he's going to hit you back for three, is what's going to happen.
He'll hit me back for three, which I block one.
Uh huh. And you get three experience, and then you get another treasure card.
Treasure. I like treasure.
Good job. Very, very good.
All right.
All right. Great work, hon. Now, one thing we failed to mention, though, is that she should have actually gotten an experience point for even exploring a major room like that. So, Dungeon Master phase, so this will increase. Unfortunately, we do have an open space, so that means that a major monster is going to...
I could ignore that.
Let's ignore it.
Ignore the Dungeon Master phase in this room.
Oh, by the way, next tile is this, too. So, yes, do that. So, ignore that. So, the Dungeon Master phase, so we will not spawn anything. The good part is, now we've got our stairs popped up, which means we are now going to go into the final battle. So, we should have this in the bag. So what I'm going to do right off the bat is, go ahead and give me the dice, but I will use this token, and all I'm going to do is explore right here. Now that will basically put us here.
Mm-hmm.
Now what happens with that is that I'll explore again. We now go into the final battle. So let's get this set up, all right? So what we do on the final battle is we just clear all this off. All this stuff just goes away. Now what happens is that I have the choice of either doing... the throne room or the sewers. All right, there is a difference between it. The sewers will have the bad guy here, two big bosses, and a bunch of other guys. And there's sewer gas. We could either lose all our treasure cards or all our gold. This is a little different. There will be a bunch of bad guys. They will spawn continuously, and he will strike from a distance. But we have no. There's no way he'll take away our cards or our coins. So. I'm probably going to choose this side, so let's go ahead and get that set up. We need a cultist on all four of these spots here. And then we will need an eyeball guy. We'll just put him off to the side. He'll pop up there. Now I need a major monster. That's an eyeball guy, which is not good. And then I need another minor monster, which hit the eyeball guy. And that'll go up here. Now I need another minor monster. All right, and that'll go here. And then we do have the final boss guy. Let's go ahead and get the camera on so you can get a good shot of him. This is him. We defeat him, and we will have won the game, so we're going to put him up here. And if you notice, he's not so tough to beat either. So we'll place him up there. And now Carmen and I have both been teleported into this room, and we are ready now to do battle with the boss guys. So the very first thing happens is that he actually triggers. So what he does is he is going to get two dice rolls. So basically he rolls this. It's an arrow. So what we do is we look to the rooms that have the arrow symbol, and that room would get one damage. So it would have been this room. If we were in there, we would have received damage. Now we roll it again, which is a shield. If we look up here, the shield is on the dragon. Mm-hmm. That means a major monster is immediately going to spawn in this room. So it's this thing, so it'll go right there. Okay. All right. So now I will roll my dice, and let's try to figure out what we're going to do here. So... I am in the room with a cultist and also a ghoul. So we know the ghoul will steal my footsteps and the cultist is going to steal my healing potions. And I rolled a lot of healing potions. I'm just going to re-roll, I think, all of these. So let's reroll all these. And, all right. So that's not too shabby, I guess. So
if
I will.
If you leave one of those, I want the, is there one that's undead? Or is there not?
The ghoul is undead.
The ghoul is undead. So leave the ghoul.
Well, I'm going to try to kill them both. Okay. So that will take this away, unfortunately, and it will take this away. So that really stinks because, yeah. Okay, so let's see what we can do now. We want to try to kill them both if we can. Let's, I think, go after the ghoul first. The bad part is I only got 3 health, man, so I really don't need to be taking a lot of wounds here. Not at all. Oh, man, oh, man.
What
I
do
really
your cards
don't.
Do?
Do
they help?
Well, they actually do. I'm going to play this. Remove all monsters from a single room. And that means that combat never ensued. Goodbye. These are gone. So there was no combat because I just swept them away. But I am stuck with these still. So let's see. Where do I want to go? Let's go, I think, up to here. And let's defeat these two guys. This guy, he worries me. I do not like the eyeball guy. I'm going to show you why the eyeball guy, the Dark Watcher. Heroes can't use any abilities while in the room with the Dark Watcher. Dark Watcher stinks.
What's the deal with this middle
thing? The thing is, see how these guys? These guys don't move. They never do. These guys can.
Yeah.
But these guys don't, okay? When you've only got one of those cultists left, you take him off the board and you spawn a Dark Watcher right here in the center of the room. That's all right. That's all happens. So typically, it's never really come into effect, to be honest. So I will use a foot token. Let's move. And I am thinking we're going to go 1 and 2. Let's move up into here. Now, something interesting about this room is that you can spend feet token and you can say, "This is Sparta!" And you can kick him into this void back here. I don't know why it's not marked anywhere on this space, but 1 foot token kicks off a level 1 monster. 2 foot token kicks off a level 2 monster.
Look
so
at that.
What I'm thinking about is that I spend a foot token and I just Sparta both of these guys right off into the void and kill them, which should technically... I'm thinking. You think? That should give me treasure cards, right? I mean, I killed them, right? I don't know about that. I'd have to look that up. That's something weird. So I killed both of them, regardless. Now, what I could do, and this might be what I end up doing, to be honest with you, is I might just stop right there.
Take
except
money.
I am going to heal. I am going to use this to turn to another healing potion. And heal again.
Oh, there you go.
And now I'm going to take a coin for this. So then that way I can have extra coins for the next round. Okay. So now what we're going to do is we are going to go into the evil phase. So let's, or the dungeon master phase. So we will pass these over to Carmen. So what happens is, not yet, we don't do that yet. So we're in the dungeon master phase. So we will increase this. We will move monsters. So we have our choice. Basically, we can move this one. And we can move this one. We can't move these guys. They always stay. All right. Now what we're going to do is we're going to go into the evil card. So, Carmen, let's see what your evil card is.
This was supposed to be your evil card.
No, really? Was that my evil card?
Yeah.
Oh, did we forget to flip mine? What does it say?
Any player must pay 4 gold, or all monsters have +1 defense until the end of the turn.
Nothing happened. It wouldn't have affected us. Okay, so this is yours. So we forgot to do mine. I'm sorry.
If any hero ends this turn in the same room as another hero, each hero in that room takes 2 wounds.
I'll just stay out of my room.
I will stay away from you.
Oh, great. Okay. So now you go into your turn, which means first he is going to activate. So he will roll 1 die. And now the room with a potion, which is me, I take 1 wound.
Wound, okay.
Now we will spawn a minor monster in with him. So 2 cultists are up there.
All right. What should I do?
Okay, he's going to cancel all of your abilities, all your cards. He is so difficult to defeat. He
cancels
stinks.
Everything.
Yes. Do you not have anything that can just get rid of him?
No. Okay.
You know what? I should have done this, and I am going to. I didn't pay attention. Choose 1 room. Ignore the dungeon master phase in that room this turn. So basically, that means he would not have moved. He would have stayed there. So then you're only going to have him. That would have made a lot more sense if I'd have done that. I just didn't pay attention.
Well, I can fight the ghost. No problem. He's undead.
It's not a ghost. That's a dragon, ain't it?
Is that a dragon?
That's a dragon.
What I'm having trouble seeing.
Where are you seeing,
I don't
a ghost?
Have my glasses.
There isn't even a ghost. Oh,
yeah, there's a
yeah,
ghost
yeah, yeah,
right
it's
above
the
dragon. See?
Yeah, that's not her. No, no.
Okay, well, I'll fight
the dragon.
Whatever,
still
I'll still take
okay,
on
so
the dragon.
So go ahead and flip that. Now you're into combat.
Okay, so four shields, and then he'll hit me for four if I don't.
Mm-hmm. Now, he'll just, basically, the first arrow he ignores. Okay.
This is not good.
You need, maybe keep the magic symbols just to try to convert into swords, because you need swords, and then keep your healing potion.
I don't know. I don't need the healing potion.
Well, it gives you a healing potion and two gold, that's all. Oh my god, are you serious?
This is the worst roll ever.
Yeah.
But that's not going to do me any good. Wow, okay. Well, I have a sword. See, he's going to... I will change this one into a shield. So then these go down here. Now I have two swords and one shield.
I think I should have gotten... This says defeat.
I will change this one into a sword. So that would give me four swords.
That would give you, if you look there, that would have given you two shields. I don't know what your situation is.
No, I'm going to heal one.
Well, you can't heal until after the battle.
Even when it's this?
Yeah, I think technically you could heal with that. Yes, I'm sorry.
Okay, so that's two, that's four sheep, the four swords and one shield.
So he's going to hit you for three.
He would hit me for three. I'm going to use this. That
there you
way
go.
He only hits me for one.
There you go.
Okay. And then I'm going to heal that immediately.
Because
that.
Of that. Yep. So he's dead. So you will get another treasure card.
And I'll get two more coins.
Mm-hmm.
Which I've got lots of coins. I'm only allowed to have six, right?
That's yes,
all
you can only
okay.
have six, yes.
Nice. All right.
Uh-huh.
And
then what can you do with these?
XP, which
that's
does
it?
Nothing.
Okay.
Doesn't help us right now.
So, all right, cool. Let's just leave it at that then,
let's
I guess.
Just,
all right. All right, and then we'll go into the Dungeon Master phase, which does mean now that this guy is going to move into here. He is going to move into there. Go ahead and pass me those. We will advance this. Also, now he is going to activate, so we'll roll one die. Arrow, bow and arrow, that's this room. And then he is going to spawn another minor monster. Okay, a skeleton. Alright, so go ahead and let's flip over my evil card. Let's see what we got. Alright, so Ceiling Rupture. The active hero must choose. Take two wounds or lose their natural ability until the end of this turn. I'll just lose my natural ability. We'll just leave it at that. I don't like that idea, but yeah. Okay, alright, so first thing first, remove all monsters from a single room. Dismiss!
Oh, these monsters right here are gone?
Oh, those monsters right
that's
there are
nice.
Gone. Darn tootin', that's nice.
So all these are gone. Whoa.
Were there three in there?
No, that one was over by the over to the side.
Oh, yeah. Okay, there we go. Alright, yes. So now, what I'm going to do is use my feet. Feet, don't fail me now! Should I do it?
Mm-hmm.
Alright, let's just go. The only thing I don't like about this is that I'm not fully healed. I'm only at 4 health, and I'm also can't use my thing. You sure you don't want to just pay the 4 coins so that I can? If any hero... Where's my card? Oh. The active hero must choose... Or, okay, I see.
I
couldn't
can't,
have paid
I
coins,
can't pay
stuff.
For you.
You don't pay coins. I was just thinking of something different.
Take two wounds or lose their natural ability. But right, okay.
That's an awful lot of wounds I could possibly take. So I can't use this ability right here either. I gotta hope I roll a lot of shields, hun.
Yeah, you could go in here.
That's gonna spawn a Dark Watcher here, though, unfortunately, if I kill
oh.
him. That's the bad part. Let's just... should I do it? There's three of them in there. None of them hit that hard, though. I think I can do this. Let's do it. Wait a minute. He'll steal a potion, right? Yeah. I don't care for that. Okay.
Can you change your potion die?
Yes, I can.
Oh, no.
Okay. Well, that wasn't good at all. Alright, so I will fight. I'll just fight him first and get it over with. So I will lose this potion. All right. I think this was a mistake. I think I'm going to die. Okay, let's see what I can do. Let's put a shield here. That'll give me two swords and one shield and a gold. Go ahead and give me my gold. All right. I am thinking that's good enough. Mm-hmm. I'll just take the one wound.
He's dead?
He's dead. All right.
Okay.
So let's just put him right there. Next, skeleton. He hits back for two as well. All right. So with skeleton... Let's spend three money. Wait, no, that's a little over. It may not matter. It really don't matter. Okay.
It doesn't make any difference.
No, spend three money. Mm-hmm. That's enough for right here. Mm-hmm. And then I'll just take the one wound.
Okay, so he's,
now he's dead.
He's dead. All right.
Okay. Now this guy. Two and two. All right, so feet, we'll go here. Give me two, I'm sorry, feet, go here. Give me two coins. I have no other way to get money. Yeah, okay. I should have probably done that first. So let's not worry about that yet. So just leave that there. Let's do this. Okay, two. That was from range. Now he flips.
Okay.
Four and six. So I have to at least defend enough where he does not kill me.
Oh boy.
And I don't think I can. Unless I do this. I'm going to use those. Turn this into a shield. If I can find it. That was my feet, right?
Yeah.
No, I don't want to change my feet. I'm going to leave my feet with that. I'm going to change this into a shield. Change this into a shield. Wait, let me think. You don't have nothing, do you? What's that teleport? It just gives
it
me
just
2 points.
It just puts me in there with you. Oh, wait. I could give you feet. Does that help you?
Feet don't help me now. This hurt, man. That hurt bad. Alright, let's stop and think. Hopefully I just didn't die. Do I have to defeat him on this side? I don't know if I have to. I'm going to double check to make sure. Let's see. Yeah, we got to defeat him on his red side. Okay, so I do have to defeat him on his red side, which means if I take two wounds, we just lost. I knew it was probably a mistake to go up there. I had a feeling it was just losing this right there. If I didn't lose that, I actually would be able to survive another round. Shoot! There's no way for me to try to get out of this, is there? I'm dead. That's it. There is absolutely no way. I mean, I could get two gold coins for that, but I can't use this ability, so I have no other way to get a gold coin, and I can't get my cards yet, because I have to fight him. If I could get my cards, then I'd be able to do it. So I think we just lost them.
Well, we showed the whole game.
Yeah.
There
so,
you go.
Yeah, that's basically it, unfortunately. So he's going to do enough points of damage to kill me, and that will end up ending the game just like that. So.
Ah.
Yeah, I thought, see, and we had enough time, so I thought we should have just waited
and
prepared.
We had enough time.
I just feel like, yeah, we rushed it, unfortunately. So, all right, well, that was it. Unfortunately, we ended up dying, which really sucks. But at the same time, yeah, you guys got to see the game. So all it meant would have boiled down to is us just killing him. That would have given us the victory. And like I said, we had enough time to do it. We just rushed it, so. Oh, well. I failed us. But you... And I knew that we had plenty of time. I don't know why we felt the need to rush up there.
Yeah, I don't know. I forgot about him flipping over and that you would have to...
I knew I was going to have to fight four. And I was like...
Yeah.
And then when I was like... I realized I was going to die. I was like, well, maybe I was wrong on that. So then I checked the rule book just to make sure. I was like, well, I really don't want to die. I was so close. Because really, if I could have survived that, you probably would have moved up on your next turn and just finished the game off. And we would have won. So...
Yeah,
a little disappointing, but is what it is. I mean, what are you going to do? You know, that's how the game works. I would have loved to have cheated. So hopefully we got everything right. I know we forgot to flip the evil card on the one time. I hopefully we caught it all. We moved the timer and all that. A lot of little things to keep track of. And it's especially difficult when you're filming because you're so focused on the filming and explaining the game, and you can easily forget one of those little bitty steps.
I know one thing in the rule book that looks like it's really hard to keep track of is the experience points. But I noticed that the experience points are generally listed somewhere, like they're on the tile or they're on the monster, and that way, you know, you don't really have to remember all that from the rule book.
So let's talk about the game we just played a little bit. You seemed like you were really just pounding away there early on. And then, you know, it really didn't feel like you were ever in a situation like what I felt like I got into several times.
With
where
a
I was
lot
like,
of monsters.
Well, just low on health and in trouble. Because your character specialized so well in healing that it didn't seem like it affected you as much as it did me.
It really bums me out when I'm not allowed to use potions. I think I had one turn where I wasn't allowed to use potions. And I need swords. I don't attack with anything else, and so not rolling swords really hurts me.
Yeah, it does, and that's the thing about this game is that you do get to roll the dice two times to try to get what you need, but that doesn't guarantee it. Now
it's only two times.
Yeah,
Zane.
What's nice is you do get the magic symbol, and you can create that as like a wild, but in a way you're wasting a die to be able to do that. Well,
you are wasting. Yeah,
a die
you are. You're using, but I think I probably should have kept the magic symbols more often than what I did.
Yeah,
would help me out, so.
Possibly. You just never know how that's going to affect you in the long run.
Yeah.
Now, there are other characters. There's a thief, there's a wizard, and there's also like a druid. And the druid, actually, what's cool is he gets like a pet, and the wizard will have it as an apprentice, and they get an extra die that could possibly be used, which most likely they will level up to be able to use it. So, and they have different abilities. I think the wizard's a little on the weak side. I don't like him as much. I would say that Carmen's character is probably one of the best. I do like my character that I played with an awful lot. The thief is very situational. The druid is pretty bad, though. I almost played with him in this one instead of my character. Now I kind of wish I did.
This game was kind of different for me. I feel like in previous games I've had more cards, more treasure cards.
We struggled with the treasure cards.
Yeah.
In the last games we played.
And I was usually using them for you because I didn't even need them because I was healing constantly. And this game, it just didn't go the same
at
all.
This game was very awkward because our last games we played, I mean, you can have like a maximum, if I remember, like 6 treasure cards. We were at the max. You can have 6 treasure cards. We were both at the max at one point in time. We went into the final battle with 12 treasure cards. That's what
But then we lost them because we went into the sewer.
Yeah, we did the sewer. That's why I didn't want to do the sewer again because we rolled the die and we lost everything. So it was like, well, screw the sewer. We'll do the throne room. That'll be easy, right? Well, then we died.
Yeah, it wasn't easy, unfortunately.
Let's talk about what we think of the game. I'll let you start off if you don't mind.
Well, my first thought is that I'm always wanting to play Super Dungeon Explorer.
Uh-huh.
But a lot of people don't want to play it because it's kind of, you know,
you
a lot of setup
and
you got to have a dungeon master. And this really scratches that Super Dungeon Explorer itch because you've got the cards
right
that you
there?
Upgrade with. And without as much setup, without as much takedown, and without needing a separate dungeon master. So in that respect, I really like this game because I'm able to play it more often.
Well... We love Arcadia Quest. Absolutely love Arcadia Quest. And this has given us the Arcadia Quest feel, but now it's given us the co-op ability because we are huge fans of co-op games. So for that, I just say absolute hats off. I just, it's phenomenal just for that aspect alone. Not to mention, I just think the gameplay is actually fantastic. It's a lot of fun.
Yeah.
It really plays, in my opinion, just like what you would expect from a dungeon crawler. You know, you're exploring, you got monsters you're constantly having to battle, you're getting treasure, you're leveling up. There's nothing that I don't like really about this game. I think it's absolutely fantastic, and it's easily going into one of my top games of the year.
I really love the mechanic of rolling the dice and assigning them in any game that has that mechanic. Mm-hmm. And, you know, this has that. I really enjoy that. Now, Arcadia Quest, I was going to say. We really enjoy that game, and but we always play against each other. I haven't tried out the competitive mode. Yeah.
Which I'll explain how competitive mode works.
I'm thinking that competitive mode in this game is probably going to be, again, a little simpler than Arcadia Quest, so it's probably going to be more likely that I'm going to play it. That's my thoughts.
The competitive mode, and that's what I like this. This game is giving you so many different ways to play. You can play competitive mode in two different ways. You could play until one person hits 16 experience, they immediately win the game, basically, and it's over with. Well, you'll finish the round, okay? And then whoever ends with the most thin.
That's nice. Yeah, I like that. Finish the round.
Yeah, the 16 experience, though, would trigger the end of the actual round, though. And then whoever ends with the most then wins. The other way you play is just like we did with our co-op mode, is that you play through the entire thing until you defeat the bad guy, and then whoever has the most experience points wins the game as well. So the end of and that's called the epic. So the end of the normal is whoever hits the 16, finish the round. The end of the epic would be that you go through the entire scenario like we just did, you kill the big bad guy, whoever has the most experience wins, and you can just basically just loop the experience track. You also play with a different treasure deck. You don't play with the Alliance, you play with the competitive treasure deck, and that's where you're playing cards to affect one another, and it gets kind of nasty. So this game has three different modes to play. It's absolutely fantastic. I just think it's a brilliant design. It's a lot of fun. The miniatures look beautiful. The production value is just through the roof. Simply a fantastic experience. I love this game an awful lot, and I can play it by myself with as many characters as I want. This is a win in my book.
Well, there you have it.
Nothing more?
I don't have anything more.
There you go. That's my feelings on it. We hope you guys enjoyed this video. And by all means, check out our other ones. And we'll have other ones for you later on this week as well. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.